Hey farmers, what's going on? Welcome back to another HayDay video. Now in this video, we're going to be talking about the two brand new machines added into the game by the latest update called as Wok Kitchen and the Fondue Pot. Now let's start the game. A lot of visitors are asking for wheat, which is cool. We're just going to sell them wheat and let's see if I have my boat ready. Let's just fill the boat. I've got a lot of, these are blue sweaters and tofu dogs. Let's just ask for help. All right. And I've got my... Wait, what was that? I think I noticed something. Kind of weird. Anyways, I've completed my chill tasks and this job is going on really well. I think it's really good for the people who like to play normal and usual game, just like me, because the reason I love this derby is because it does not bound me only to certain things. I can play my town and fishing area as usual while completing my tasks as well. So you guys can see that I've done corn tasks, the town visitor tasks, and I've done the fishing and soup tasks. Let's just harvest some crops. I've got some broccoli and potatoes. All right. Got an eel. That's cool. And a land deed. Also, guys, I want to announce that I will be putting a really big sale tomorrow, 12:30 p.m. Eastern Time, which basically is 10 p.m. at night for India or 9:30 p.m. in Pakistan. That will be approximately 23 hours after this video is posted. So if you want to purchase some tools, please come to my shop and I will be selling them. I'll be selling land tools, town tools, some mine tools, and some axes as well. So yeah, if you want to get some tools, it's a really good opportunity. Don't miss this out. Anyways, now, before I start the video, actually, I'm just going to plant something. Let's see what we need. I'm going to go with some soybeans and the carrots. Now, the reason why I'm putting a sale is because I was saving these tools for the update, you guys know. But when the update came, there's nothing relating to the town buildings or the land. So these all are basically useless for me. I can trade them, but I'm basically not in the mode of trading. I just want to make some coins, so I'm just going to sell them all approximately. All right, now first of all, I want to apologize for not showing you guys the unwrapping part and expanding my slots part. Because when I first recorded this video, it somehow got deleted. I couldn't save it. So I just want to apologize for that. I feel really bad. But anyways, let's have a look at these machines. All right, guys, the first machine that is added in this update is called as Wok Kitchen. Unlocks at level 69, 350,000 gold coins, and it takes about 3 days and 7 hours to be built, which I think is a lot of time, right? Second machine that is added is called as the Fondue Pot. Unlocks at level 81. It costs you 800,000 gold coins, and it takes about 4 days to be built, which is also a really, really long time. And the design of this machine is my favorite. Now let's just have a close look at the design of this beautiful machine called the Wok Kitchen. So we start by the two stools that are under that board, which is a pink board. It looks really pretty. You can see there's a tray, a knife cutting onions. You can see there are, that are like green onions, olive oil, a lot of sauces, that's ketchup, some balls, and a big fry pan on the flame. It's covered with the lid and something is cooking inside. So I can actually smell what's going on. It's really cool. It looks really, really beautiful. So there you go. You can see this machine. And coming back to my favorite machine called is the Fondue Pot, which also has a heart sign on it. I don't know what does that mean. Now, to me, this pot, this big pot, basically looks like a pot of a witch. Like, you know, what we watch in the movies and the shows, those demon witches has this kind of pot and they just try to curse everybody around, stuff like that. So it looks really cool and you can see the flame is on. Then we go down, we can see there are three stools, there are some utensils there. You can see that's probably cheese being roasted on a tray. And I personally love the design of this machine and the color, the red and this seems like it's kind of blue color. I'm not really sure if it's blue. It's kind of the mixture of blue and green. It looks really, really cool. And you can see that cloths are there as well. Now, each of these two new machines make 3 different products. So you've got total 6 products from these two new machines. So you can see that I've made some fried rice and spicy fish, and I'm just going to collect them. So let's see how many XP do I get from collecting the products. All right. 1 white rice gives me 24 XP, which is cool. 1 spicy fish gives me, wow, that is a lot. 65 XP for 1 spicy fish. I'm going to tap on that. Brilliant. And the last product of this machine thing, which is basically tofu stir fry. I'm gonna speed it up, all right? And it gives me 37 XP. Now, I'm just gonna turn the volume a little bit on so you guys can actually hear how does this machine sound. Wow, so it sounds just like your barbecue grill, like something is being grilled, something is being fried inside. Now, the first product, fried rice, unlocks at level 69. It needs 5 eggs and 5 rice, which I think is really cool. For me, the big challenge is definitely going to be rice, because I, of course, need them to make a lot of sushi as well. So, yeah, 1 R, and I'm already making 1. The next product is spicy fish, which seems delicious. 1 fish, 5 garlic, 3 chili peppers, and 1 olive oil. Takes about 1 hour and 30 minutes, which I think is cool. The last product unlocks at level 89, and the spicy fish unlocks at level 79, so it's a difference of 10 levels. Tofu stir fry, 3 soybeans, 3 broccoli, 3 onions, and 3 sesame seeds. And it takes about 1 hour and 15 minutes to be produced. So I'm just going to put this inside, and it looks really yummy. Now, having a look at the mastery of this machine, 140 hours for the first star, and you guys can see they've already run it for 3 hours. Second star will give you 5% more XP from the truck otters, and when you finally get the third star, your products will be produced 15% faster. And I think the mastery is similar to the previous machines, right? Now, if we have a look at the products, all of them take over 1 hour, and all of them do not need something which is very hard. For example, product. So I think this machine is actually very easy to master. Just open the slots and put this machine on work. You can make a lot of tofu stir fry. You can make a lot of fried rice if you want to master it, and then you can sell them. I can't wait to make a lot of fried rice and sell them because I love fried rice. So yeah, I think it's really cool, and this machine is going to be really easy to master. But not this one. Coming to the fondue pot, we also have 3 new products. You can see that I've made some, so I'm going to be collecting them. Let's see how much XP do I get. Wow, 74 for 1 chocolate fondue. That seems like it's a bacon fondue, 60 XP. And I've made some cheese fondue, 59 XP. Cool. Now, this machine, I've also opened 5 slots by spending some diamonds, and I couldn't show you guys that part. Looking at the mastery, this machine has 90 hours. You can see that I'm running for like about 1 hour, and it feels like its total time will be less than the previous machines. And it's also going to be really, really hard to fully master. So the first product is the chocolate fondue, requiring 1 chocolate bar and 3 strawberries, unlocks at level 81. Let's put 1. It only takes about 25 minutes, which is very low, I guess. The second product unlocks at level 86 is bacon fondue, 3 bacons, 1 broccoli, 1 bell pepper, and 1 olive oil. It takes about 30 minutes. I'm just gonna sell that. Cheese fondue, then again, it's very challenging. It's gonna need, potato bread and cheese, 2 mushrooms, and 1 tomato. Now, why this machine is really hard to master? There are 2 reasons. First of all the products take very less time. Only 20 to 30 minutes, which I think is not a lot. Secondly, you're gonna need a lot of important things. For example, you're gonna need a lot of cheese, a lot of potato breads, and the chocolate bars, which I think are really very challenging. For example, if I go to the candy maker, 1 chocolate bar takes about 17 hours to be produced, which I think is insane. And coming back to the bakery, potato bread, which also takes a lot of time, and it's then again, it's gonna need a lot of butter and white sugar. So make sure you keep running your sugar mill and your dairy if you want to make a lot of these products. That is why I feel like HayDay should give us more dairies or sugar mills in the game, because I think it's gonna get a little bit challenging now because we have these new products. Now, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go to the shop and have a look at the price of these new products. So let's just go ahead down and down. I've got one of them right now, and let's see. All right, so coming to the chocolate fondue goes for $6.26, which is a lot. Wow, so the 10 will approximately go for $6,000. But I do not recommend selling them because it's really important. So 1 bacon fondue goes for 507 coins, and 10 will approximately go for 5,000 coins. Amazing. All right, and where's the cheese fondue? Yeah, 1 cheese fondue go for 93 coins, and it's 10 will approximately go for like 4,000, right? So all of the fondue products are really expensive. But then again, I do not recommend selling them because they need a lot of important things. Coming to the Wok Kitchen, we've got our beautiful, amazing, freshly made fried rice. 1 goes for 205 coins, which I think is okay. You can sell them because the ingredients are not that hard. The tofu stir fry, 306 coins, which again is a very good way to make coins because it only needs vegetables. And the last product is your spicy fish, which is really expensive. One goes for 543 coins, and 10 will go for about approximately more than 5,000 gold coins. But I don't recommend selling them. Save them for your town and boats. So yeah, that was it for two new machines. I know a lot of players have been requesting for ages that we want new machines. So yeah, finally HayDay listened to the players and brought us two brand new machines. Now, as you all know that I love to master my machines, so that's what I'm gonna do now. I'm gonna keep making new products all the time. That's my Wok Kitchen. Tomorrow I'm putting a sale. So if you wanna get some tools, please visit my farm tomorrow at 12:30 PM Eastern Time. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please subscribe if you wanna see some more of HayDay videos, and I'll see you soon. Thanks for watching. Bye.